Hi everyone, list in ascending order of reactivity with bromine and aluminium tribromide the following compounds and predict the structure of the name product. Structure A is paramethyl phenol, so the structure of this first paramethyl phenol will be, this is the structure, this is the phenol, and in para position there is a phenyl group. So this is structure 1, paramethyl phenol. Next, structure B is nitrobenzene. This is nitrobenzene. Structure 3 is phenol. This is structure 3. And structure 4 is meta-iodotoluene. This is structure 4, this is structure 2. Now we need to list the order of reactivity with the bromine and aluminium bromide. Now aluminium bromide is the Lewis acid. Octet is incomplete. Okay, two electrons are, the octet is not complete. Okay, if you see the structure of aluminium bromide, this is the structure of aluminium. So we need two more electrons for the octet to get complete. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only 6 electrons are there. Two more electrons are there. That's why this behaves as a Lewis acid. And why do we use aluminium bromide? So that we can polarize this bromine, non-polar molecule. Okay. This aluminium bromide, it polarizes the non-polar bromine molecule. Okay. There's an electron distortion. There will be partial negative charge, partial positive charge. Okay. So this partial negative bromine ion will attack the electron deficient center of the aluminium ion, and it will form what? AlBr4- and bromonium ion will be released. Now we'll see how this bromonium ion will attack on these four different products. In the first product, this CH3 is an ortho and paradirectoring group, so it will attack the bromine. Bromonium ion will attack this compound at the ortho and para position. But at ortho or para position we have hydroxyl group. Okay, so this bromonium ion will attack only at the ortho position of the CH3 group. So this will be the product of this reaction. This will be slow. Why? Because OH minus ion will exert a negative effect also. By negative inductive effect, it will destabilize the ring. By resonance effect, it will stabilize the ring. So both of will oppose each other. Both the effects will oppose each other, thereby reducing the reactivity. Phenol doesn't react with bromine and aluminium bromide. Okay, it reacts only with the bromine water. Okay, it doesn't react with this reagent. Okay, it reacts only with bromine water, which is a polar water, which is a water is a polar solvent. Okay, so it reacts with the bromine water to form 2,4,6 dibromo phenol. When this phenol will react with an inert solvent, no, carbon disulfide or carbon tetrachloride, then only ortho product or para product will be formed. But in this case, it will be 2,4,6 tribromo phenol. So phenol will be the least reactive in this case. Then nitrobenzene, if it will react bromonium ion, we know nitrobenzene is a meta directing group. So this bromonium ion will attack the meta position of nitrobenzene to form meta bromo nitrobenzene. Okay, this bromonium ion will attack the meta position because here it is a partial negative center. Rest the ortho and para position of this nitrobenzene occupies a positive center. We can see in the resonating structures of nitrobenzene. That's why this bromonium ion will attack the negatively rich electron rich center, which is the meta center. Next, structure 4. Again, CH3 is an ortho and para directing group. So the bromonium will ion, here you can see the both the and ortho position is also empty, para position is also empty. So this bromonium ion will attack this ortho position as well as the para position. So in one product we'll get an ortho substituted product, and in the other one we'll get a para substituted product. So in this case there's iodine also. So iodine will, what will iodine do? Iodine will try to exert negative effect or pressor effect. Okay, this there also the both the factors will be opposing, but ye factors utna dominate nahi kar pata hai kyunki yahan pe bromine ko attack karna hota hai humne ko ortho and para position. CH3 only deals with the ortho and para position, so it doesn't, this iodine effect is very very much less. Okay, so the most reactive compound is compound 2, then the compound 4, then compound 1, and then compound 3. This is the ascending order of reactivity of these compounds.